What are we doing to find this guy?
Well, I promised the doc we'd take him alive. So, after you blow him all to hell, put one in his leg so we can say we tried.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Jason Voorhees is cryogenically frozen. He wakes up on a spaceship 400 years later. The year is 2550 to be exact. It really upsets me that somewhere down the line, filmmakers lost sight of what a Jason movie really is. The Friday the 13th franchise was huge in the 1980s. It's kind of a big deal. And to make a Jason Voorhees movie that takes place in outer space is kind of an insult to the franchise. Now, what makes these movies so special is that critics and parents shamed these films, calling them cheap exploitation movies. And that just made teenagers want to watch them even more. But when I look at a movie like Jason X, I think to myself, what in the holy hell were these people smoking? Putting Jason in outer space was a terrible idea. Unfortunately, this piece of garbage is what fans got while the movie studio settled their legal differences in order to give us Freddy vs. Jason. Fans waited 7 long years after the Jason Goes to Hell ending to finally get Freddy vs. Jason. So in the meantime, filmmakers gave us Jason X to kind of tide us over. Gee, thanks. So Jason X was directed by Jim Isaac. He's also known for directing Arachnophobia, Gremlins, Look Who's Talking To, 3 movies that I absolutely love. Oh, and for Star Wars fans, he did Return of the Jedi also. It feels like the Friday the 13th franchise died after Part 6 Jason Lives, which coincidentally, that's when Kane Hodder came on board to take on the Jason Voorhees role. Now, I can appreciate and respect that Kane Hodder really put his stamp on the Jason character, playing Jason 4 times in a row, but I always preferred Richard Brooker and Ted White. Hell, even CJ Graham. Kane definitely has his moments as Jason, but I could point out a Kane Hodder Jason from like a million miles away. So anyway, Jason X came out in the year 2001, which is right around the time that studios really started incorporating CGI technology into their movies. Unfortunately, at this time, CGI was in its beginning stages technologically, and it definitely shows on Jason X. The CGI has not aged well at all. This movie has a fucking robot in it, or android, whatever you want to call it. We get a scene where Jason has a one-on-one showdown with the android.
You guys might want to run.
What's up with Kane Hodder and all these versus roles? First we get Jason versus Carrie in Part 7 The New Blood, and now we get Jason versus a robot. But he just couldn't land the Freddy versus Jason role, the one that actually matters. Jason's look is god-awful as well, I must say. I missed the old days where they actually put a little effort into Jason's design. Even Uber Jason looks stupid. Hey, the hockey mask in this movie looks like the same mask from the 2009 remake. It pisses me off because Jason has a full head of hair in this movie, and you can clearly see his skin around his eyes and under his fingerless gloves. That's just lazy if you ask me. Jason died in the final chapter and then got resurrected in Jason Lives, and from that point forward, Jason was zombie Jason. But I guess they forgot about that or just didn't give a shit. Speaking of Jason Lives, there's a scene in this movie that reminds me of a scene from Jason Lives. This guy actually offers Jason money not to kill him. Like, are you shitting me? Just like in Jason Lives, how director Tom McLaughlin's wife offered Jason a few bucks and a credit card. Only that scene was much better. My god, the CGI was so bad in this movie. The characters were all horseshit. This movie sucks. But yes, I did manage to discover a few positive things about Jason X. I was reading that when they made Part 7, The New Blood, the MPAA made John Carl Buechler cut the sleeping bag kill scene. Originally, Kane Hodder smashed the girl up against the tree quite a few times, but they made him cut it down to just one single hit against the tree. Well, I like how they explored that in Jason X. They put Uber Jason in this simulation scenario with 2 topless chicks in their sleeping bags. And what can I say? Jason beats the bullshit out of them.
Hey, you want a beer?
Or do you want to smoke some pot?
Or we can have premarital sex.
But I guess nowadays it's okay. I also liked how this movie had little bits and pieces of the original Friday the 13th score. That gave me a little sense of nostalgia. I can't say that it fit the movie, but it was still appreciated all the same. They had Manfredini do the score, which he's the one who did the original one, that classic Friday the 13th score from part one. And then the kills in Jason X. There was some real creativity with some of these kills. We all know and love the famous frozen face head smash kill. And then when Jason throws that dude over the railing and he lands on that giant screw thingy and his body like twirls downward on it.
Keep your eyes peeled.
Of course they ruin it with some bad comedy. In fact, this movie had too much comedy in it. Like, are we watching a horror movie or a goddamn comedy?
Besides, we found Condor.
What's his condition?
He's screwed.
Yeah, Jason X is retarded, but I'm still glad that I've finally wrapped up my Friday the 13th marathon and can start making my ranking video. I watched every single movie in this franchise, and I feel like I've become an expert on Friday the 13th. I give Jason X a 0.5 out of 5 rating. I really don't recommend this movie, but I don't know. If you like futuristic space movies, you may enjoy it. Okay, folks, that's it for my Jason X movie review. Did you guys enjoy this video? Do me a favor and hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell so you can receive notifications every time I upload shit. Alright y'all, I'm gonna get out of here. My name's Justin Ray. Y'all be safe. I love you guys as always. Have a good day. I'll see you guys on this side or the other side. Peace, folks.